Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today, join my family as we explore a brand new grocery store in our area. Come on in and see what we see. Stay tuned to the end for a grocery haul. Exploring our new Piggly Wiggly grocery store, and it is absolutely beautiful. Everything is so neat and straight and organized and clean. We are just having the best time. These pre-packaged soups from Spoon and Ladle look so delicious. Savannah is already scoping out which ones she wants to take back to Auburn with her after spring break. Piggly Wiggly carries the Priester's pecan pies. These pies are fantastic, and I can already tell you what my family will be having this year as dessert at Thanksgiving.
This is a reenactment of her reaction.
These pre-cooked and pre-packaged casseroles sure would make getting dinner on the table in the evening so much easier. I had never seen these Taco Bell tortilla chips before. We didn't pick up a bag this time, but I can almost guarantee you we'll be trying a bag in the very near future. Never tried the Blue Spring bottled water before, but I love that it's bottled right here in Alabama.
Okay, we are home from Piggly Wiggly, and we thought we would show you really quick what we bought. All right, you're up. Are you going to start?
Since it's on a dog.
A big dog. Where's the little one?
Why can't we take turns?
Where's the little one? Okay, come here. Let's show him you. Yes.
Mother.
Oh.
Okay. So we'll start with the unhealthy things that I bought.
It's ridiculous.
I just had to try it. It's banana pudding, Nilla cereal. I mean, I had to try it. So I'll let you know if I like it. Or I just try it right now.
She's gonna like it.
You go ahead and tell while I try this.
I got these. The Hello?
Microwave.
The RX Bar Nut Butter Packs. This is the vanilla almond
Does
butter
it want
one.
Some cereal?
It tastes like birthday cake.
Oh, it has little, look, the little marshmallows are like the meringue. I'm sorry.
Jenny tasted it, she loved it.
And then I just got one of the honey cinnamon peanut butter ones to try it. These are good. This is probably good. She doesn't like it.
It does not taste. It does not taste like banana pudding.
Just another thing I'll have to eat.
Taste it.
Does it taste like a vanilla wafer?
It's very artificial banana tasting.
Oh.
Good.
He likes it. Okay, good. As I'm still eating it.
No, no, release it.
The little white things are good.
The marshmallows.
They're good. But I don't like the little cookie parts.
But just use it as dog treats.
That's true.
You're going to kill my dog. That has so much sugar.
The white dog is mine.
It has, it's kind of an artificial banana taste. I'm not a big fan. Maybe in milk it would like mellow it a little bit. All right, are you going?
Okay. I already went, you interrupted me 15
times. Okay, so we got some Zevia strawberry. I've never tried it, but it's strawberry, it has to be good.
I don't think so.
So I love Zevia, she likes LaCroix, but.
The Perrier is better than LaCroix, I think.
Okay. I can't quite get on board with those, but I do like the Zevias. So I'm excited to try these. Okay. Did you already show them this?
No.
Hubby picked out the Luigi's Real Italian Ice. It has blue raspberry and watermelon. And this is what y'all eat at Talladega, is that right?
No.
Something very similar.
Okay, so they get some kind of shaved ice thing.
They give me acid reflux.
Okay, so we got that. Okay.
I want to put it in the freezer.
Well, I will.
I got Bob's Red Mill gluten-free pancake mix.
Gluten-free pancake mix with no dairy.
It's hard to find.
It's a big deal.
Really hard
to
find.
So yay for Bob's Red Mill.
Oh, also from the same brand, I'm going to try their protein powder. It's chocolate and it's pea protein. So.
It's very good. How many grams of protein?
20 for 2 scoops.
That's good. Any sugar? 2 sugars?
2, not bad. 18 carbs.
Okay. It's a little bit higher in carbs, but not bad because after you work out, you need carbs.
Yeah.
So that's good.
There's also a lot of recipes on the back of it.
Oh, that's fun.
And this one has probiotics in it.
That's good.
From chicory root.
Rich in iron. 220 milligrams of omega-3s.
And it, did I say it was pea protein?
Yes.
It's pea protein.
Got some red plums. And we're going to try, I've always wanted to try these. So we got some. Star fruit.
Do you eat the peeling?
I don't know. We don't know what to do with them. So we're going to Google it. But we're going to try star fruit tonight.
Apples.
Apples. Green apples. And I also got the, what do they call these? They call them English cucumbers. It's supposed to be a seedless cucumber, I think.
They're good.
So they're more expensive than other cucumbers. So it better be
they're
good.
They're big.
That's true. It's like 2 cucumbers in one.
It evens out.
Okay, I'll put this in the freezer.
Mini wheats. Little mini wheats.
Did you say baby wheat?
Yeah.
Okay.
We got a lot of oatmeal.
Yes, we did.
This is low
sugar.
More Bob.
More Bob's Red Mill. Yay.
Gluten-free.
You haven't been able to find those in Auburn, right?
No.
So that's exciting.
They're both
apple.
Good. Apple pieces and cinnamon and brown sugar maple.
Okay, did I talk about the...
No, you didn't.
Apples and cinnamon, maple, brown sugar, cinnamon and spice. Lower sugar variety, so this only has 4 grams of sugar versus the regular flavored oatmeals have 12 grams of sugar.
I'm laughing because there's 53 servings in this.
I had never seen this before. It's called Tasty Shakes, and they had several different flavors. They had like strawberry, yeah. And this is apple cinnamon.
It's like oatmeal seasoning.
But you shake it on your oatmeal. How cute is that?
Or you use the whole thing.
Or not. And throwback to childhood days of eating with my grandmother on holidays. She always had red spiced apple rings. So... And your big mama had them too, right, babe?
Nope.
Okay, so hubby grew up eating them. I grew up eating them. Have you ever eaten them?
Nope.
Oh, the tradition died. We're bad parents.
Actually, I think I've had one. I didn't like it.
I think you did. So yeah, we got these. Y'all have to let me know if you ever had one. It may just be a southern thing. So let me know if you've ever had red spice apple rings.
Stonewall Kitchen.
Piggly Wiggly had a lot of Stonewall Kitchen stuff.
Butternut squash pasta sauce.
Oh,
what else needs to go in the fridge?
GF, low sodium, soy sauce.
That's very hard to find. Gluten-free is hard enough to find, but low sodium gluten-free? So that's exciting.
Dried apricots, that way you ate in the car. Old Bay because I threw it away.
If you didn't see the video back in the beginning of January when Miss Organized here was decluttering our spices.
I threw away every spice we owned.
Yeah. So hubby's been all upset every time he cooks seafood because we haven't had this. So we have it. And when does it expire?
She better not touch it.
I'm going to throw it away.
I don't know when it expires. But how did you find an expiration?
I don't know. Maybe I didn't know and I just threw it away anyway. I did that for some of them.
It's powder. It doesn't expire.
Yes, it does.
Our Mrs. Dash that she threw away was like a brick. Did you tell you everything?
Okay. Butter beans with
Vidalia?
Vidalia onions.
Well, hubby wanted to try these. He loves the butter beans. I could. Come on, boys.
It's not focusing. This flavor's good. I like it.
Okay guys, I'm going to end the video right here. I've got 2 puppy dogs that are very anxious to eat. Oh, and a cat too.
A cutie cat too. Silly baby, want to eat?
Bless you. Okay, so it is dinner time for the animals. So we will see you guys next time.
Say subscribe and like because Shelly is beautiful.
Thanks for watching.
Bye bye. Bye bye, Jenny.
Okay, come on, let's eat.
Bye bye.
Whoa!
Hunter!
Also got excited about supper time.
That did me a fright. How do I turn this off?